थैंक यू कीर्तना मैडम फॉर ए ग्रैंड बिगिनिंग एंड थैंक यू दिव्यावाणी मैडम फॉर गिविंग माय इंट्रोडक्शंस एंड ऑल. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल रेस्पेक्टेड चेयरमैन श्री एम लक्ष्मण रेड्डी सर, रेस्पेक्टेड एग्जीक्यूटिव डायरेक्टर श्री जी चंद्रशेखर यादव सर एंड चीफ गेस्ट ऑफ टुडेज प्रोग्राम डॉक्टर सेल्वो कुमार हु इज ए प्रोफेसर इन एशिया पैसिफिक यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड इनोवेशन मलेशिया. Convener of this program, Dr. B. Hari Krishna, Professor and HOD of EC Department. Program Coordinator, Professor Venkanna Mood, EC Department. Advisory Committee Member, Deans, HODs, Invited Guests, Organizing Committee Members, and faculty of this EC Department, students of this department, last but not the least, the participant across the country, a very good morning to all of you. I am Dr. Santosh Kumar Patro, principal of St. Martin Engineering College. Wholeheartedly, I would like to welcome you all to this AICT-sponsored one-week online STTP, which is titled as Medical Image Processing and its application in automated disease detection. And this is our phase three, which we are starting from today, and it will go up to 24th of June. So already the phase one and phase two are completed by the department. So at the outset, first, I would like to extend my thankfulness and gratitude to AICTE for considering our proposal and giving the approval and permitting us to continue all the three phase of this title for the benefit of the society and for the benefit of the teaching community. And in addition to that, I would like to extend my thankfulness and I would like to congratulate the convener, Dr. B. Hari Krishna, for successfully completing 11th events, and this is your 12th event. And I have witnessed past all the 11 events were mega success. So again, a big round of congratulations to you as well as to your entire staff member. It shows the dedication and determination whatever you and your team has put, and that started showing it in a colorful way. So my sincere appreciation to the entire department, including the convener of this program. And based on my information, already you have scheduled your international conference also in the next month. So I wish all the very best for that program too. So, and as the title suggests about the medical image processing and its application in automated disease detection. See, this is in a very vibrant area where a lot of researches are happening. And this is what I feel this is the need of the hour, because it is automated disease detection. And what is disease and how severe it could be, it is known to every individual now. Because for almost 1.5 year, so this on and off lockdown is imposed, and because of this pandemic, and somewhere every day we were thinking about one aspect is what treatment, another aspect is what prevention, and the third important aspect now everybody is talking about disease detection. And if that could be done through a automatic tool, then that will add lot of feeders to the system. And see, this medical image processing and its application, it is not a new concept for us. Okay, so when from decades we were using the different images to detect the diseases and its severity, and all these images already all of you would have heard, like we use X-ray, we use CT scan, we use MRI scan. There are different types of varieties of scannings are there, which normally helpful to diagnosis and to detect a particular disease. But here exactly, now in this pandemic situation, if some tools or some systems which can be developed in the form of an expert system to identify or to detect the disease by using the medical images, especially for the COVID-19 pandemic, then it will be a really a blessings for the mankind. And I understood that there are already a lot of researches are going on, and there are some partially successful models are also available with us today, which takes the medical image as an input, and it will tell us the disease detection, and also it will advise us the treatment plan. Just to narrate few, because there is a tool named as COVIDNet, and COVIDNet, what it does, it takes the chest X-ray of any individual, and also by using the deep learning model, it will able to tell us that what is the percentage of COVID-19 infection in that particular patient. And because of this early detections and all, one best advantages is what, we can isolate the patient and we can start treatment at the earliest. Similarly, I came across another tool named as Blue Dot. So Blue Dot is also an artificial intelligence driven tool, which also help us for using it and also identifying the disease at the early stage and suggest the treatment. So there are several AI based computer vision cameras are also deployed across the world to scan the crowd, and from the crowd, the camera has got the capability of identifying the COVID-19 patients from the crowd itself by seeing the symptoms and monitoring the people during the lockdown. Because as you know, soon after this lockdown will be withdrawn, so people, those who are infected, people, those who are partially infected, by avoiding all guidelines, they will be coming out. And once they are coming out, we do not have any mechanism to identify their infection percentage and isolate them and suggest them the treatment. So now we have AI tools with using the medical image processing and by using the different high definition cameras from the crowd itself, they will be identified so that we can isolate them and start the treatment. So I really appreciate the department for choosing such a very good concept and which is need of the hour, and providing the facility for all the teaching community. And at this junction, I would like to again say my thankfulness and gratitude to Dr. Selva Kumar, as I know very well that how busy one academician could be even though during this pandemic, but sir is kind enough and given his consent to be with us and also going to enlighten us with the knowledge what already he is having. So thank you very much, sir, for agreeing our invitation and for be with us and also to spend time with us. So again, at the outset, I would like to wish all the very best to the department and congratulate. And also I would like to wish all the very best to all the participants to have a great learning. So thank you for the opportunity and do take care of yourself. And thanks for listening to me. Have a great day ahead. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your